to tell you the glandular epithelium. So first the glands. So what is the gland? Or what is the glandular epithelium? A gland is a group of the cells by cells of body that synthesize the substance like the hormone, sweat, saliva, mucus, or the acid for the release into the bloodstream or into the cavity inside the body or its outer surface. So name is given this gland or the glandular epithelium. You see this diagram. A gland is an organ of secretion made of specialized secretory cells derived from surface epithelium on which it opens. Previous I would tell you the epithelium. So epithelium means there is a rest basement membrane, and the, on the basement membrane there is resting the tight junction of these cells. So this one are the basement membrane, this surface part are the epithelium. So depending upon the type of these cells, so epithelium name is given like this. So these are the basement membrane, and inside and within this basement, above the basement membrane, there is a epithelial cells. When this epithelial cells is runs downward, and there is a formation of this gland. So there is a formation of the secretory portion, and this one are the connective tissue, and here there is a duct. So this part are the glandular tissue. So gland is an organ of secretion made of specialized secretory cells. So this one are the secretory cells derived from the surface epithelium on which it opens. So this one are the surface epithelium. So this how you can define the glandular tissue or the gland. So gland is a group of the cell body that synthesize substance like hormone, sweat, saliva, mucus or acid for release into the bloodstream or into the cavity inside the body and its in outer surface. So what is the character features? So how the glandular epithelium is formed? Here you can see this proliferation of the cells and their downgrowth into the subjacent connective tissue. So this one are the basement membrane, these cells are the epithelial cells, and here there is a connective tissue. So when this epithelial cells is runs downward, and there is a formation of this gland. If there is a duct is present, this gland name is given this exocrine gland. If there is a duct is absent, this gland is name is given this endocrine gland. So cord of the cells forming the endocrine gland. So here there is a two type of this gland. If there is a duct legs, the duct is present, so this type of this gland is exocrine gland. If there is a cord or of the cells forming the endocrine gland, there is absent the disappearance of the duct cells. So this type of this gland name is given this endocrine gland. And here there is a surrounding, there is a capillary and secretory portion. So this how the glandular epithelium is formed. So what is the character features of the glandular epithelium? So gland is originated from the specialized secretory epithelial cells. So these are the epithelial cells. Usme se form hoti hai glandular tissue. And it leaves the surface from that develop from this permanent into the underlying connective tissue and from the basal lamina around them. Glandular epithelium is formed by the cells specialized to form secretion. The secretory molecules are stored in the cells in small membrane bound vesicle called the secretory granules. The glandular cells may synthesize, store, and secrete the protein, lipid, or the complex of the carbohydrate and protein. So gland are under hormone or the nervous control, third chemical messenger. They may be exocrine or endocrine. If there is a duct is present, so this type of this glandular tissue name is given this exocrine gland. If there is a absent or the disappearance of this duct, this type of this gland forming name is given this endocrine gland. In follicular endocrine gland formation, here there is a surrounding glandular substance within this exocrine gland, name is given this part of this endocrine part. Now central features of the glandular, general features of the glandular epithelium. You see this already I told you the general features. The gland can be present as discrete organ or in the layer of this viscera. Secretory cells of the gland from the function unit secretory and piece. Epithelium in origin. Fluid secreted by the gland, either enzyme, hormones, mucus or fat. Rate of the secretion is modulated by the nervous and the hormonal influence in myoepithelial cells. So this one are the glandular tissue, the general features of the glandular tissue. Now, classification of the gland, it is based on the number of the cells. First classification of gland according to the number of the cells, first are the unicellular, second one are the multicellular. So unicellular jo gland hai, usme unicellular gland are the interspread among the other. So non-secretory epithelial cells, they can be found in the epithelium lining the intestine. Example, goblet cells. So these upon are the example of the unicellular gland. In case of this second one is the multicellular gland. If there is a multicellular gland, most gland are multicellular. Such gland develop as a diverticula from the epithelium surface. The distal part of the diverticula develop into the secretory element, while the proximal part from the duct through which secretion reach the epithelial surface. Lacrimal gland, parotid gland, these all are the example of the multicellular gland. Now second one, according to the presence of the excretory duct, either exocrine gland, duct gland, or the endocrine gland, duct lex gland, and pancreatic gland, this one are the both exocrine and endocrine part. So based on this exocrine gland, site of the secretion, exocrine gland, that pour their secretion into the epithelial surface directly through the duct are called the exocrine gland. Extending secretion gland, example salivary gland, all three salivary gland, this one are the exocrine gland, parotid, submandibular and sublingual salivary gland. And endocrine gland, some gland lose all contact with the epithelial surface from which they develop and they pour their secretion into the blood. Such gland are called the endocrine gland. Internally, secreting gland or the ductless gland, they secrete the product for the basal lamina into the bloodstream. Example, thyroid gland, pituitary gland and adrenal gland. All are the gland are the endocrine gland. Also name is given this ductless gland. And second one are the, third one are the pancreatic gland. So in the pancreatic gland, that secrete the hormone which has effect only in the vicinity of the gland secreting it hormone that diffuse to short distance to other cells. Example, enteroendocrine cells of the GAT tract. So this one are the isolate of this Langerhans. It is the part of this endocrine part of this pancreatic gland, and rest of this part of this are the exocrine. So this one are the classification of the glandular epithelium. Now according to the number of the cells, unicellular and multicellular, you can see this example of this goblet cells. Goblet cells are the unicellular in example. Here you can see this unicellular cells, this one are the goblet cells. So according to the number of the cells, it is disappear individually among the epithelium of the GAT respiratory tract. They protect the lining. They derive their name from the shape like the goblet. They have thin basal and the expanded apical part. Cytoplasm is filled with membrane bound secretory droplets which displace the cytoplasm to the periphery and push the nucleus through toward the base. So these are the example of this unicellular gland or the goblet. Second, according to the presence of this excretory duct, so exocrine gland, endocrine gland and the parotid and pancreatic gland. So this one are the example of this gland based on this nature of this either there is presence of this duct. If there is a duct is present, these are the exocrine gland. If the duct is disappeared, this one are the endocrine gland. Now classification of exocrine gland according to the branching pattern of the duct, according to the shape of secretory unit and according to the manner of this secretion. So based branching pattern of the duct, see there is a branching pattern. According to the branching pattern of the duct, and according to the shape of the secretory unit. So here there is a based on the mode of secretion. First there is a based on mode of the manner of the secretion. So first, according to the branching pattern of this duct, simple tubular with duct and branch tubular acinyl. So these are the either it is simple tubular or the branch. So shape of the secretory unit, tubular gland and SNR gland and alveolar gland. So you can see this first shape. These are the simple tubular with duct. So based on the branching of the duct, either it is simple and compound. If there is a simple, all the secretory cells of the exocrine gland discharge into the one duct. Example, gastric gland and the sweet gland. And compound mein kya hota hai? There are the number of this group of the secretory cells. Each group discharging into the own duct. This duct unite to form the large duct that ultimately drain onto the epithelial surface. Example, parotid gland and pancreatic gland. Based on the shape of the secretory unit. So pattern of the duct according to the branching pattern of the duct. So both is simple and compound gland. Secretory cells may be arranged in various way. Tubular glands, gland with secretory unit, tubular in shape. The tube may be straight, coiled, or the branch. Example, gastric gland. So this tubular gland, either it may be straight, coiled, or the branch. Name is given this tubular gland. Another is acinar gland. Gland with secretory unit round or oval in shape. Example, salivary gland. So if there is a simple tubular with duct and branch tubular acinar. Here there is a simple tubular secretory unit, simple tubular without duct. Here there is a simple tubular with duct. If duct is present with simple tubular and duct is disappear, name is given this simple tubular without duct. So tubular gland with secretory unit, tubules in shape. A tube may be straight, coil or branch. Example, gastric gland. So here there is a gastric gland. This one are the example of this tubular gland. Now second, simple coil tubular gland. If there is a tubular gland, it is coil like structures. Name is given this simple, but it is coil tubular gland. So this one are this simple coil tubular gland. Example of this sebaceous gland. So simple coil tubular gland, secretory portion are the coil in shape. So this appearance name is given this simple but coil tubular gland. Third one, simple branch tubular gland. So simple branch tubular gland, here there is a simple but here there is a two tubules, so it divide into this branching pattern with duct. So simple branch tubular gland, this one are the example of this simple branch tubular gland. Fundic gland of the stomach, this part are the gastric gland. It is the one of this example of this simple branch tubular gland. Fourth one, simple acinar on the alveolar gland. So acinar jo gland hai with the secretory unit round or the oval in shape. Example, salivary gland. So here there is a secretory portion or the simple acinar. So this part are the either mucus or the penile erythra, mucus gland of the penile erythra. This one are the example of the simple acinar or alveolar gland. Acinar gland, example, salivary glands and alveolar glands with secretion unit flask shape. However, it may be not that the term acini and alveoli are often used as if they were synonyms. Gland in which the secretory element are greatly distinct are called the secular gland. So combination of this earlier may be present in single gland from what has been based on earlier. So unicellular, simple tubular, simple alveolar, compound tubular, compound alveolar and compound tubular alveolar gland. So these all are the classification or combination of this gland. Simple branch acinar or alveolar gland. Example, meibomian gland of this eyelid and sebaceous gland of this skin. This one are the simple acinar or alveolar gland. So here there is a duct is present, secretory portion are acinar type and there is a alveolar type. So simple branch acinar or alveolar gland. This one are the example of this sebaceous gland. Here you can see this one are the sebaceous gland, erector pylor of muscles. These muscles are the erector pylor of muscles, shaft of this hair follicle, and in this epithelium are this nativar squamous non-keratinase, keratinase epithelium, and here there is a glandular structure or the sebaceous gland. This one are the example of this simple branch acinar or tubular gland. Another gland are the meibomian gland of this eyelid. Now third is compound tubular gland. So here you can see this branch duct is present, secretory portion, it is branch tubular, and here there is a Brunner's gland of duodenum, cardiac gland of the stomach, and the bulbourethral gland. This one are the example of this compound tubular gland. So this all are the based on the shape of this gland, based on the either it is unicellular or multicellular, based on the nature of the secretion, based on the mode of the secretion, based on the branching of the duct, based on the shape of the secretory unit. These all are the classification depending upon its mode of secretion and branching pattern. Compound alveolar gland, here there is a branch acinar alveolar part. Example, mammary gland, exocrine plant of, part of this pancreas. These are the example of this compound alveolar gland. Now compound tubular alveolar gland, here secretory portion. Here there is tube like structures, branching tubular acinar part, duct is present. Example, submandibular gland, pancreas, prostate, gland of the respiratory tract. This one all are the example of this compound tubular alveolar gland. Now according to the method of the secretion, either merocrine, eccrine, epicrine, or the secretion is thrown out of the cells by process of the exocytosis. So according to the mode of this secretion, so what is the merocrine gland? Merocrine gland, it is the type of this exocrine gland. The secretion is released by the exocytosis without losing a part of the secretory cells. Example, salivary gland, some sweat gland, and the pancreas. These one are the merocrine gland. Second one are the apocrine gland. In case of this apocrine gland, here you can see this apical part of the cells are seed off to discharge the secretion. Example, mammary gland and atypical sweat gland. So apocrine gland, small apical part of the cells is released along with the secretory product. Example, sweat gland in the axilla, alveolar, areola, and nipple of the breast, ear canal, eyelid, wings of the nostril, and the some part of this external genitalia. These are the example of this apocrine gland. One are the holocrine gland. In case of this holocrine gland, as the secretory cells mature, it dies and become the secretory product, sebaceous gland and the tarsal gland. Here, entire cells disintegrated while the discharge its secretion. Example, sebaceous gland and the tarsal gland. This one are the holocrine gland. So cytocrine or the cytogenetic gland. So what is the cytocrine? In testis, the cells are released as secretion. So these cells are the released as a secretion. This type of this mode of secretion name is again cytocrine. So example, testis, a bone marrow, and ovary. These all are the cytocrine or the cytogenic gland. So these are the based on the mode of secretion. First one, according to the type of the secretion. So either nature of the secretion are serous, mucous, or mix. Serous gland, mucous gland, and mixed gland. So serous gland, the secretion of the serous gland are the protein in nature. Cells secrete the enzyme, rich watery fluid. Cells of the serous acini are triangular in shape with a round nucleus. Their nuclei are centrally placed. Example, pancreas. So this one are the mode of the secretion are serous in type. Name is given this serous gland. According to the mucous gland, so mucous gland, the secretion contain the mucopolysaccharide. Cells secrete the mucus, which is thick, viscous, and the jelly-like protective lubricant known as the mucin. Cells of the mucous acini are tall with flat nuclei at their base. The lumen of this acini is larger than the serous acini. Goblet cells, minor salivary gland of the tongue and the palate. This one are the example of the mucous gland. Third one are the mixed gland. So in the mixed gland, glandular contain the acini that secrete both mucous and serous secretion. Example, submandibular and sublingual gland. This one are the example of the serous, mucous, and mixed gland. So what is the demulens? So serous demulens means mucous acini are kept by the serous cells. in form of this half moon or the concentric shape structure. Following their appearance, they are called the serous demilunes. So these are the two difference between the serous and mucous acini. So parameter difference between serous and mucous acini. Here you can see this diagram. This one are the serous gland. This one are the mucous gland. This one are the serous acinus and mucous acinus. What is the difference between this serous and mucous acini? So serous acini are size of the acini are smaller, but mucous are larger. Lumen of acini in serous narrow, in mucous wide. Shape of the cells in serous pyramidal in shape, in mucous low columnar shape. Shape of this nucleus in serous rounded, and here mucous there is a flattened. Portion of the nucleus in serous central, in mucous basal. Basal part of the cytoplasm serous ma basophilic, mucous acini ma less basophilic. Apical part of the cytoplasm in serous acini acidophilic, and mucous acini appear spongy due to the mucigen granule. Apical microvilli present in serous acini and absent in mucous acini. So these are the two difference between the serous and mucous acini. And duct of the salivary gland, interlobar and interlobular duct can be seen embedded into the connective tissue of the lobe and the lobules of the gland. Interlobar duct can be seen in the connective tissue between the lobe and aligned by this stratified cuboidal or stratified columnar epithelium. An intralobar duct can be seen in between the secretory acini within the lobule. Intralobular duct can be divided into the intercalated duct and the striated duct. The secretory acini empty into the intercalated duct, which merge into the striated duct. Intercalated duct aligned by the cuboidal epithelium and striated duct aligned by the columnar epithelium. The striations of the striated duct are the found in the basal part of the cytoplasm of the cells. Example, parotid gland. General pattern of the salivary gland is maintained. The parotid gland contains the serous acini predominantly. Sublingual gland contain the mucous acini predominantly. So submandibular gland, general pattern salivary gland, there is a both serous and mucous acini and few serous demilune. But in case of the sublingual gland, here there is a pure predominantly mucous and contain serous demilune. So this one are the complete the class of this glandular epithelium. So any question, please tell me. Okay, thank you.